Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters.
Good afternoon, Father.
We include in this Mass our personal intentions. We pray for our families, friends, and relatives. And we also pray for all the souls in purgatory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, through the yearly observance of Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to the whole assembly of the children of Israel, and tell them, be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy. You shall not steal. You shall not lie or speak falsely to one another. You shall not swear falsely by my name, thus profaning the name of your God. I am the Lord. You shall not defraud or rob your neighbor. You shall not withhold overnight the wages of your day laborer. You shall not curse the deaf or put a stumbling block in front of the blind, but you shall fear your God. I am the Lord. You shall not act dishonestly in rendering judgment. Show neither partiality to the weak, nor deference to the mighty, but judge your fellow men justly. You shall not go about spreading slander among your kin, nor shall you stand by idly when your neighbor's life is at stake. I am the Lord. You shall not bear hatred for your brother in your heart. Though you may have to reprove him, do not incur sin because of him. Take no revenge and cherish no grudges against your fellow countrymen. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord." The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Your words, Lord, are spirit and life.
Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple.
Your words, Lord, are spirit and life.
The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye.
Your words, Lord, are spirit and life.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just.
Your words, Lord, are spirit and life.
Let the words of my mouth and the thought of my heart find favor before you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer.
Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. Let us all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his righteous throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from one another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on the right, 'Come, you are blessed by my Father. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink, a stranger and you welcomed me, naked and you clothed me, ill and you cared for me, in prison you have visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill or in prison, you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or ill, or in prison, and not minister to your needs?' He will answer them, 'Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me.' And this will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang hapon pong muli sa inyong lahat. Ako po tuwang-tuwa sapagkat bago po ako magsampung taong pari ngayong darating na Mayo, ay nakasama ko po sa misa ang aking dating formator sa theology, si Reverend Father Babaylon. Siya po ang dati naming provincial superior ng Missionaries of Faith, at siya po ngayon ay kasalukuyang naka-assign sa aming general house sa Italy. At wala po kaming usap na siya'y pupunta dito, nagkita lang po kami dyan kanina sa labas, at siya'y naanyayahan kong magmisa. Thank you po, Father Bob. At welcome po sa Parish and National Shrine of St. Padre Pio. Tingnan niyo po ang inyong mga katabi. Yan. Nakikita niyo ba si Jesus sa katabi ninyo? Yan. Nararamdaman mo ba si Jesus sa kanya? Do we see God in other people? Tandaan natin, mga minamahal ko, mga kapatid, na tayo ay huhusgahan ng Diyos kung paano tayo namuhay, kung paano tayo nakitungo, kung paano tayo nagpakita ng pagmamalasakit, at kung papaano tayo nagpahalaga sa ating kapwa. This is what our gospel is telling us today. There will be a day of judgment. When the Son of Man comes in His glory, and all the angels with Him, He will sit upon His throne, and all the nations will be assembled before Him, and He will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on His right and the goats on His left. This reminds us that time will come when the Messiah will gather all the people in the world and separate each of them, those who will be rewarded in heaven and those who will be tormented in hell. San kaya tayo mapapabilang? Sa mga tupa ba o sa mga kambing? Sa mga pagkakalooban ng buhay na walang hanggan o doon sa mga parurusahan? Paano ba tayong namumuhay? To be on Jesus' side means we care for the poor, the needy, the sick, the lonely. Sabi ng Panginoon, "Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me." Inaanyayahan tayo ng Panginoon na maging generous, maging mapagbigay. At hindi lamang pag sinabing mapagbigay ay material na bagay ng ating naiisip, kundi maraming bagay tayong pwedeng maibigay, yung ating panahon, yung ating pakikinig. At share ko lang po sa inyo, si Father Bob po, nung siya ay aming rektor sa seminaryo, masipag po yan, pinagluluto po kami ng tanghalian, kasi wala kami po sa religious, sa missionaries of faith po, wala po kaming tagaluto, kami ang nagluluto. Siya pong nagluluto para sa amin, pagtanghali, kasi kami galing sa school. Pag-uwi po namin, nakapagluto na po siya. At kung minsan, pag siguro ay nakikita niyang ang dami na naming labahan sa aming mga laundry basket, kasi nandun po sa laundry namin yung mga laundry basket namin, nandun yung mga labahan namin, pag-uwi namin, laban na lahat. At sasabihin niya sa amin, "Nilaban ko na yung mga damit nyo. Mamaya, tuyo na yon, tiklopin nyo na lang." So, thank you po, Father Bob. Ganun po siya kabait sa amin. Kaya nung kami po ay naging pari, talagang pasasalamat namin sa kanya. Bilang isang pari, bilang isang seminarista nung panahon na yon, napakabait ng pari ito. Isang leader, gumagabay sa amin, pero yung ginagawa niya, sobra pa sa isang leader, sobra pa sa isang kapatid. Kaya kami nagpapasalamat sa kanya. Mga minamahal ko, mga kapatid, ano kaya ang kwento sa atin ng ibang tao ng kabutihan na ating ginawa na hindi ina-expect na kaya nating gawin para sa kanila, lalong-lalo na sa mga nangangailangan ng tulong, lalong-lalo na sa mga nahihirapan? Ano kaya ang ating kayang gawin para sa kanila? At ito yung inaanyayahan tayo ng Panginoon. God is inviting us to help other people, to be generous, to share how we care. At higit sa lahat, ipadama natin ang presensya ng Diyos sa kanila. May we become selfless, genuine, and show authentic love to one another. Amen.
For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets. Let us all stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
May this devout oblation be acceptable to you, O Lord, that by your power it may sanctify our manner of life, and gain for us your conciliation and pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Those who cannot kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gilbert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Please all stand.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Those who cannot kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The second collection, which will be done, is for the continuing development of the parish and national shrine of St. Padre Pio and for the needs of welfare and the sick and retired priests of the Archdiocese of Lipa. Thank you for your offering. Please all stand.
Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that in receiving your sacrament, we may experience help in mind and body, so that kept safe in both, we may glory in the fullness of heavenly healing. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer for intercession to Saint Padre Pio. Padre Pio, holy monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon on this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage, with you are our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our help, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that you concede. Bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled. From sin may we abstain, in God may we remain. We also beseech thee, servant of the Most Holy, to instruct us in the gospel, that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee. Our hearts repent, resolving earnestly to not sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit and Jesus the Mediator. Amen. Please be seated for some announcements. Una, sa inyong pagdalaw sa Pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ang inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, mga kapiyo, kami po ay humihingi na inyong kaunting oras at pakikiisa para sa pagsusulat ng inyong mga pangalan at ilang detalye sa ating Pilgrims Information Record Books na makikita sa paligid ng ating mga simbahan. Ito po ay bahagi ng documentation program para sa pagpapalawig ng mga datos at turismong pangsimbahan at bilang alaala din ng inyong pagbisita sa Pambansang Dambana. Para po sa ating mga balikbayan, OFW at mga kasama niyong foreigners, dun po kayo magsusulat sa International Pilgrims Record Book. Gagabayan po kayo ng ating mga tagapaglingkod. Archdiocesan Centers for Reconciliation at bahagi ng pagsasakripisyo ngayong panahon ng Kwaresma, tayo po ay inaanyayahang mangumpisal at magsisi sa ating mga kasalanan. Makikita po ninyo sa screen ang mga confession schedule. Gayon din naman, mayroon po tayong pagdarasal ng Istasyon ng Krus tuwing araw ng Biyernes sa ganap na ikatatlo ng hapon. Ang aklat dasalan po ay available sa ating mga tindahan. Ikalima, mga kapiyo, bahagi pa din ang ating pagpapalalim ng pananampalataya at pagninilay ngayong panahon ng Kwaresma. Ang ating lakbay parokya ay gagawin natin sa ilang mga simbahan sa Pampanga sa darating na March 21, 2024. Para sa mga nagnanais sumama, kayo po ay magpalista sa opisina ng parokya sa halagang 2,500 piso hanggang ngayong March 10 lamang. Ika-anim, ngayon po ay magkakaroon ng gawain ng simbahan ng mga dambana at basilika ng Pilipinas para sa kanilang taunang pagsasama-sama. Dahil dito ay pansamantalang wala po tayong misa ng 10:00 ng umaga sa Biyernes upang bigyan daan ang kanilang mga pagdiriwang. Ikapito, sa darating pong Biyernes sa 23 ng buwan, ang araw ng pagpapagaling ng Panginoon sa pamamagitan ni Santo Padre Pio, ang mga oras ng healing mass at healing liturgy na may paggagawad ng langis ay sa ganap na 9:00 ng umaga at 5:00 ng hapon. Kayo at ang inyong mga may sakit ay inaanyayahan. Maraming salamat po at mangyaring panatilihin natin ang kalinisan, katahimikan at diwa ng pananalangin sa loob at labas ng ating mga simbahan. Magsitayo na po ang lahat para sa pagbabasbas na religious articles.
Mga kapatid, manalangin tayo sa Diyos Amang makapangyarihan upang tayo ay maging kawangis ni Kristo sa timtim na pagdalangin sa tulong ng mga larawan at mga dasalan. O Panginoong Diyos, Ikaw ang bukal ng lahat ng pagpapala at biyaya. Ibuhos mo ang iyong bendisyon sa mga gamit na ito sa pananalangin. Mga rosaryo, imahen, dasalan na nagpapaalala ng iyong kabutihan, kabanalan at pagmamahal sa amin, upang ang lahat na dumulog at magdasal gamit ang mga ito ay magtamo ng iyong awa at biyaya. Loobin mong tularan nila ang kabanalan at aral ng Panginoon at ang mga santo magpasawalang hanggan.
Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Maraming salamat po muli sa inyong pakikiisa sa banal na pagdiriwang na ito. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Walang sino man ang nabubuhay para sa sarili lamang. Walang sino man ang namamatay para sa sarili.